Greetings, Earthlings! Welcome back to my channel, the only Lauren channel. Of course, I am the Lauren, only Lauren, the only Lauren. And today's episode, we are going to be talking about fight your parents, story time, I went to jail. And I know this is quite controversial, you know. I've been hearing that, oh, I don't look like a gangsta. They've been calling me Gangsta Lauren in different places because, you know, basically this or whatever. And basically what I want to say is because we live in a society where I guess a lot of people are seeking attention. A lot of people, like I talked about in the relationship video, people need acceptance, attention, validation, and ultimately power. And we live in a society that's built on taking all those things away from people. And a lot of times our parents have gone under that, you know, that process for many years under that process. Now I'm being very nice and kind about that, but I'm telling you, like, put the pop, boom boom pop. Now listen, I'm a Cancer rising, so you know the fight gonna be at home. I'm saying, and the fight was with, you know what I'm saying, is, so that's just how it is. I'm a thug, can't be scared. So basically I'll be saying to y'all, you need to fight your parents. And I think this is, you know, I've been seeing a lot of people say this too, like they talked about the hurt, like the extreme hurt from their parents, because it happened from their parents to their parents. And like I said before, society, and a lot of times our parents are too afraid to go out and like live life and basically like get their needs met. So they use their kids by any means, shape, or form to get those needs fulfilled. So then that's where the conflict comes at. So but it's important to do this, because if you don't, you're going to pay it forward to the next generation. You might have, maybe you may not be significantly violent towards your kids, like a lot of us had, but your kids are going to be lacking in some way, shape, or form. So if you don't give yourself the attention, validation, acceptance, and the power that you need, and if you don't fight your parents for the stuff that they did, I'm telling you, you're going to suffer for it. I'm telling you, I fought both of them, both. I ain't cussed out my grandma. Yeah. I'm telling you, okay? These are my confessions. I'm only confessing to help you guys. And then, probably the only reason, like, my other grandma didn't get got is because she irritate enough, but not enough to get got. So she know just when to stop. And then, you know, I'm gonna say, like, you can't be afraid of these older people. You can't be afraid of older authorities. Like, if I don't have respect for you, you being disrespectful to me, I'm gonna fight you. That's just what it is. But I'm gonna tell y'all about jail, because I ain't allowed to talk about my case. So here it is. Okay. So, but it was so much fun. Like, you have no idea. I had so much fun in jail. Basically, so I got arrested, right? And then, is that the part of the case? I don't know, but I guess I'll just tell you about the part in jail. So they take my stuff or whatever, right? He takes my phone. He was like, you know what, I hope you have a good life. You know, you need to get your head up, get your life together, get your head straight. You know what I'm saying? You got so much to live for. I was like, okay, cool, officer. Deuce. Dad. And then, oh, the old-fashioned dad. Not dad. And then, so there was a lady in there. She was skinny, you know, like a crackhead, kind of ugly. And then she was like to the lady that was working there, she was like, "You fat bitch, da da da." She was sitting at the front. She didn't want to do nothing that they said. And then she was like, "Well, you know, the fat bitch, the person that was, the lady that was working there was like, well, you know what? I don't know. At least I'm getting money." You know, it was kind of ghetto up in the jail. So, like, she was getting back with her. And so I was like, okay. And then, so I was eating my sandwich, right? Because they give you a sandwich. And so I was eating the sandwich. I was chopping on it. And then one of the girls that was getting ready to go inside the prison to the upper room with me, I didn't know at the time, I'd never been. She was like, "Oh, you need to put on your face mask." I put on my face mask. I'm like, you know, she kind of like the authorities, you know. I don't have a problem taking, you know, rules from other people who are just regular people, you know what I'm saying? You, like, it's no big deal, cause you know, we all on the same wave. And so, you know, so I just put my mask on, I'm like, okay. And so, but she was like, cause she was like afterwards too, you know, we gonna out here catch Corona and everything. It's not safe out here. So I was like, okay, I'm eating a sandwich. So basically we go to the upper room, They take my thing or whatever. The guy was like, "Oh, I went to jail because, you know, I wanted a coffee and I went to Starbucks and I was using a credit card and the credit card was mine. And so they called on someone." I was like, "Oh, you know, you could have just asked for a free coffee or whatever." Now, mind you, that's probably not what happened, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I try not to incriminate myself like that, because I'd be like, you know, you either think I was guilty or you don't. So that's what I'm saying. So then, yeah, and he was saying that, and I don't know if I'm allowed to talk about his case, but anyway, so then, okay, it was so much fun, because then we ended up, got up there, right? And there was this girl, and she was like, "Yeah, I can't be here, I can't stay here, I'm pregnant." She was holding her belly with this, it just looked like a gut, right? Turns out she actually was pregnant later on, like when I tell this story. And so we were up there, right? And then we started talking, like, right, or whatever, you know. I started talking to them, they started talking to me, like, we all just started talking, you know, chit-chatting, vibing. They were like, "Okay, yeah, you should be out of here pretty soon," whatever. She told us everything to say. So basically, okay, so she was a Gemini. She was so smart as far as the criminal justice and the law system was, that she actually should be working that job because she knew so much about the system, because she had so much experience that she was able to coach all of us. And so what would she say? Like, I actually had a mini lawyer inside of the jail prison waiting room with me. Oh, okay, so let me tell you the part. Okay, so they went and took my mug shot. I was smiling, and my mug shot, I'm smiling like cheesing. And then, cause I didn't see any reason why I should be mugged, like me mugging up. And then, so yeah, so we ended up being like a girl group's friend, like girlfriends or friends. And then girls, because they put the guys separate than the girls. And then, but I ended up making friends. And then, I ended up making friends. We got each other's Instagram. We ended up being a crew just for that small moment. Then I went to the trial, the mini trial or the giant trial with all of us together. And then I think I was guilty for now or something. I'm not allowed to talk about my case. Anyway, so I went to jail. And then basically when I went to jail, it was like so interesting. It made me feel like Akon or something, or like freaking Martin Lawrence, and not Danny DeVito, Eddie Murphy. When I went into jail, and I was like, but I wasn't like freaking out or anything, because I knew I didn't belong in jail. Just like a birthday, I just want to fly free. But it was so cool when I went in there. So I go in there, right? And then it was cold. It was very cold. You know, the place is all built with brick. You know, I'm walking down this road. You know, I got to ask for my own stuff. Like, can I get some blankets? They didn't give me any blankets till way, way, way later. They were like, oh, they're not ready yet. You know, they give you food. They give you food. The food is pretty decent. But then they had me in the cell, right? So I was in the cell alone. But what had happened was, okay, I went to go talk to the one lady and whatever, the prison guard or whatever. And I'm like, hey, can I talk to my lawyer? And she was like, oh, you know, I don't know your lawyer's name. And I was like, can I talk to my lawyer? Like, I kept asking, like, I need to talk to my lawyer. This is my life. Like, I literally said that. And then she ignored me, right? So when she, okay, so she was like, Lauren, da-da-da, she said my name, whatever. I was asleep, whatever. And then she was like, Lauren, da-da-da, she kept saying Lauren, Lauren, Lauren. So I ignored her. I made sure I opened up the door immediately because I could hear you, but I'm ignoring you. Since you want to ignore me, I'm going to ignore you, right? So I want you to know that your disrespect is being reciprocated and being disrespected. So, and then after that, so I walked down like a thug that I was. I did my hair, okay? I made sure that my hair was done, made sure I didn't go looking raggedy when I go in front of the judge. She was impressed. I basically charmed my way out of jail. I'm not allowed to talk about my case. I'm just telling you. But basically, the whole place was, yeah, I charmed my way out of jail. So, she was impressed. So basically, but the girls were really nice. They were really, really nice. They were thugs. We all like thugged out together. We linked up together. Obviously, I was the leader of the group. I told the security, I was flirting with one of the security guards. He was a white, tall security guard. He was kind of handsome-ish, you know. He was handsome, but like in a creepy 19s, 20s way. So he was like, hey, I was like, hey. And then there was a girl, she was in solitary confinement. I looked at her and she waved at me and I waved back and I was like, cool. And then there was like the bad bitch. She's the baddest bitch. So I went and made friends with her. And then I was like, hey, what's your name? Da, da. And she's like, I'm this, da, da, da. But it's like, cause you know, women, they're not giving it, I don't know, whatever. And basically I just made friends, but I almost, you know, I almost had one of them we will rock you moments up in there because, you know, that's how much I was like having a good time. I had a good time up in there. And then I was telling this one girl like, hey, you know, this is what you can do to get out. You need to tell them. You need to tell them you got kids, you got this, you got that, this, that. You know, I didn't know. I was just telling her what the other girl told me from before, you know, this is how you can help yourself. So with that being said, yeah. But so she basically was like trying to get out of there. I think she probably got out of there now that I told her like, hey, you can get out. So, you know, I think that, and that's why I think everyone should have an education. But basically that place was like super inhumane. To summarize what the experience was, like I had a good time. Because, you know, I'm coming from a person like, oh, this is interesting to me. This is a new world. You know, like, I'm being very childlike about this, not taking this, like, serious because, like, I know I don't belong here. And so, but it was, like, super inhumane. Like, it's very, very cold. I was very cold. I ended up, like, stealing two blankets. I just took more blankets and pillows. And then, it was very cold. And their toilet, and they have the toilet right there. It's kind of nasty, you know. Like I said, the food was actually pretty decent. I think they try to do health wise or whatever. Yeah, but I forgot to tell you, when you come down from the upper room, when you get ready to go to jail or whatever, they have you like strip down all your clothes, all your dignity or whatever. That's another thing too that's very inhumane. They have you like strip down and like spread your cheeks. Okay, I didn't spread my cheeks, but they basically have you stripped down. You guys don't know me, but I'm very, 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 when I say very shy, I'm very shy. So I like this. So you're like, I don't want to see you anymore, but you want to be seen. And then they had like, it was just crazy, like inhumane. They were like, the tampons, whatever, they were on the ground, on the floor. Like, if y'all want a box, the box, these were empty boxes. These weren't used tampons. They were like, if this is the tampon you want, go get your tampons. So basically that's it. So like and subscribe. Well, let me end it a little bit nicer. So yeah, that's basically it. I just don't think I think the justice system should be made up more of people who have already went to jail. Just like my friend who was in my crew with me. The law system. I think the law system is okay in fairness. I just think that for all preventative measures and everything in this life, you need to have an education. So it's like, you might have real life experience, but you need theoretical education along with your experimental education. There was like freaking a Sag stellium going towards the South Node. I don't know what that means. Not now, but I'm saying there's something significant happening between your practical education versus your experimental theoretical education. And I'm very pro theoretical education being put into your practical education. I do believe you need philosophy in your life. So that's pretty much it, you guys. I said like, subscribe, share this video, and buy my book Quintessence on Amazon for your purchase. Bye, Earthlings.